Have you put your data to work? Brockhaus, Applied Data Intelligence, Clean Rooms, makes a series of e-learning lectures. This section will be on service cleanliness. In section 2, we discussed already the measurement methods, and here we will look more at the use and application of service cleanliness. Service cleanliness. Foreign materials on a surface we call surface contamination. This foreign material can be particles, can be chemicals, can be microorganisms. They can be in the shape of films or in the as molecules. In this session we will focus on particles. When we look at a product surface, it can get contaminated by deposition of particles or by contact transfer. When we manufacture a part, often by machining, we remove a part of the bulk material, and the surface will be contaminated by machining liquids, and they are removed by a cleaning process. Then, from deposition of particles from the environment will contaminate the surface again. Also, contact with tools, workbenches, packaging materials will contaminate the surface. When necessary, a product can be cleaned again. When we look at cleaning, the cleaning is divided into three steps. You have a pre-cleaning to be able to do a good cleaning, and you have a precision cleaning. Especially precision cleaning is important for products which are used in the clean room, because we really want to remove the last particles which can affect the application of the product. The surface cleanliness is expressed in the amount of unwanted material on the surface. This can be done in grams per square meters, but for clean room products, we often count the number of particles per square meter. This can be done under a microscope, and then we see the silhouette of a particle, and the largest size of the particle, we call the particle size D. There are a number of standards on surface cleanliness, but we should realize that what we want to know is the number of particles which are larger than the critical particle size. Standards have different ways of expressing this, but once you know the number of particles per square meter or per square centimeter of your product, you can easily transfer that in the language of a standard. So standards are from the clean room world, ISO 14644 part 9 from 2012, or from the cleaning standard 14644 part 13 from 2017, or the US standard, which is used in, for instance, space industry, the IEST standard contamination control 1246E from 2015. In automotive industry, we mostly use the standard on road vehicles, which is ISO 16232, which is from 2007 and derived from the VDA 19. I will now go through the use of surface cleanliness, the way it is expressed in the different standards. I'll start with ISO 14644 part 9 from 2012, which looks at the number of particles larger or equal 1 micrometer per square meter. It assumes that the number of particles is proportional to the particle size. So if you have 100,000 per square meter, which is expressed in the logarithmic value, which is 5, so it's been called ISO SOP 5, surface cleanliness per particle concentration. So if this is 100,000, that means that you have 100,000 particles larger or equal 1 micrometer per square meter, or 10,000 particles larger than 10 micrometer, or 1,000 particles larger than 100 micrometers. You can also look per square centimeter, because then the 100,000 becomes 10 and there's only one particle larger than 10 micrometer per square centimeter. The table gives the different maximum concentrations for the different surface cleanliness classes, the logarithmic values, for a set of particle sizes. Smaller than 1 micrometer, but that's not very practical, but 1 micrometer, 5 micrometer, 10, 50, 100, and 500. And they treat 500 as the largest particle. In ISO 16232, the particle size bins are given by codes. So we have code B for particles between 5 and 15 micrometers. We have code C for particles between 15 and 25 micrometers, code D for particles between 25 and 50 micrometers, and so on. You can have a look at the table in the slide. The maximum number of particles per particle size range is given by a number which is in fact the power of 2. So if this is, for instance, 5, that means that no more than 2 to the power 5, which is 32 particles. And then that way you can describe the cleanliness of a product for different particle size ranges. So for example, you could say the specifications for these products is B15, C13, D12, E10, F7, G and H5, and so on. And then B15 means that for particles between 5 and 15 micrometers, there should be no more than 2 to the power 15, which is 32,000 particles, are allowed. And the rest you can have a look at the table, how it's worked out. But the interesting thing is that you can, for all different particle sizes, you can make different classifications, while in the ISO standard for clean rooms, you use one number for the whole range of particles. In the United States, there is an old standard, the military standard on surface cleanliness, called 1246. Especially version C is used a lot in space industry, but also for determining the cleanliness of packaging. A few years ago, IST took over the management of this standard, and in 2015, the E version is issued, like called IST Standard Contamination Control 1246E 2015. This standard expresses the surface cleanliness of a part, and it expresses the surface cleanliness of a part which has just been cleaned. So that means that there are not many large particles, and the number of smaller particles is proportional higher. So you get a distribution which looks like the square of a logarithmic distribution. So it's a Gaussian distribution. The classification is based on the largest particle which is allowed on a square foot. So if you have, for instance, let's say 300, surface level 300, that means no more than one particle larger than 300 micrometers on a square foot, which is a 10 square meter. And then for the smaller particles, a number of particles is given, like the particles larger than 100 micrometers, 50 and 25. And so you have for different classes, and each class has a different type of particle size distribution. This standard also gives by letters the amount of chemical contamination, but that one I will not discuss here. So now it's interesting to have a look, how can you use this standards. Mostly you use the standard which fits by the type of industry you are in, or the type of client you have. So American space, you use the American standard. People who are in the clean room world, you can use the clean room standard, which is more or less derived from surface cleanliness, derived from particle deposition, or the automotive standards, which is used for parts for a gearbox or a motor and so on, which are mostly measured indirectly. So the result of a surface cleanliness measurement is a particle size distribution, so a number of particles between special particle size bins, like particles between 15, 25, 25, 50, and so on. In the cleanroom standard, we make a cumulative distribution of it. In the automotive standard, you keep the differential distribution. In the American standard, you also make a cumulative distribution again. And once you have the number, then you can just look at the graph, and I've put here an example where I put the lines of the cleanroom standard and the lines of the American standard together, and your area, like in this example, I made a red circle. I put it on a plot of the concentration and the particle size, and then you can see, okay, this is below a certain standard line, and then you can use that standard depending on the industry you are in. Although I discussed already the way you can measure surface cleanliness, I'll give a quick review. You can measure the surface cleanliness directly by taking a microscope or an optical sensor on the surface of the product or the surface of interest, and you count the particles. But you can also do it indirectly by taking the product and spraying or cleaning ultrasonic this product and removing all the particles which are on the outside of this object, and you collect the water with the particles you have removed, and this water you can examine with a liquid particle counter, or you can filter it, and then you take the filter to the microscope and you count the particles under the microscope. There is a third method. You take a tacky roll, and you roll it over your surface. You collect the particles from the surface, and you can re-roll this again on the other tacky surface, and then you have a surface which you can put under the microscope and count particles again. So, if you have done a surface cleanliness measurement, you get a differential particle size, which you have some particle size bins, and for each particle size bin you have a number of particles which have been measured. This differential distribution you can recalculate into a cumulative distribution. That's what you can see on the table, where I have put a number of particle size bins, the measurement values, and then the calculation of the cumulative number, and then I've divided it by the area of the measured surface, and then you get the number of particles for each particle size per square centimeters, and that you can recalculate into a surface cleanliness level. Surface cleanliness level, SCL, I mostly use when I look at the number of particles per square centimeters. You can multiply by 10,000, then you get the number of particles per square meter. When you take the logarithmic value, then you can compare it with the ISO 14644 part 9 standard. You can also make a graph, a log-log graph, so in the x-axis logarithmic value of the particle size, and vertical the logarithmic value of the concentration. When you draw this distribution, then the tangent of this curve, that is in fact your surface cleanliness level. And the surface cleanliness level is in fact the maximum product of number of particles per area times particle size. When you have a clean surface, it will get contaminated by particles from the air. How fast a surface will get contaminated depends on the particle deposition rate. In the next section, I will explain a little bit more on particle deposition rate. But you can say that the number of particles which will come onto the surface is proportional to the surface area times the time it has been exposed and your particle deposition rate. So the general surface cleanliness will increase by the particle deposition rate and the time between cleaning. because every time you clean all the surfaces in your room or of your product, the concentration will go down, and then it will increase again by deposition. In this slide, I've given an example, and so I have to look a few times to the screen to explain the example. We have a clean surface which has a surface cleanliness level of SCP or ISO SCP 5. That means 100,000 particles largely equal 1 micrometer per square meter, or 10,000 particles larger than 10 micrometers per square meter, or 10 particles larger, or 1 particle larger than 10 micrometer per square centimeter. When the particle deposition rate is 5,000 particles larger than 10 micrometer per square meter per hour, and I expose the surface for 8 hours under these conditions, then the surface cleanliness will increase with 40,000 particles larger than 10 micrometer. So the total will be 50,000 particles larger than 10 micrometers. So that means that when I look at the number of particles larger or equal 1 micrometer, it will be 500,000. And when I take the logarithmic value, I get SCP 5.7. So in this case, we go from SCP 5 to SCP 5.7 within 8 hours. And that way you can use surface cleanliness levels in combination with particle deposition rates to see how fast the surface becomes dirty, and you can also use it to determine how often you have to clean. So I had explained how you can measure the surface cleanliness of an object, but you can also make an estimate. If you have just cleaned the surface and you expose it and you know the particle deposition rate level in that area, and you know how long it's exposed, you can also just make a prediction what the surface cleanliness will be. This is in fact the product of particle deposition rate level times the time of exposure, and that will give you the change in surface cleanliness level, or in 10 to the power ISO SCP, which is a bit more complicated. The time of exposure is important and will only give you will only have a particle deposition if the clean room or the environment is in operation. At rest, the particle deposition will be zero. The particle deposition rate depends on ventilation of the clean room, discipline of the people, and the cleaning program. Thank you for your attention. I look forward to see you in the next section 5 on particle deposition rate.